Good morning, guys and gals. I'm Pal, and welcome back to Pikmin. Yesterday, we cleared out the Citadel of Spiders, paving the way for the final cave, the Submerged Castle. This will be the day we've waited for. No, this will be the day that I complete the debt, but this will also be the day that we fight one of the biggest mysteries of the Pikmin series, and one of the most important story aspects of the Pikmin trilogy. Alright, so, starting out the day, I'm taking out a squad of 100 blues. That's right, 100 blues. Waiting for all of them to come out. Alright, we're going to split the squad off into... Actually, no. We're going to take all of them. We're taking all of them. I was going to split them off into two, because then Louis could start getting some sprays, but actually, I believe, as I speak weirdly for some reason, I believe that we need both captains in order to get the last above-ground treasure, which we need to get. I did say that I would do some off-screen calculations as to how the how our Poco count measures up with what I need to get, and I did that. And it looks like we will be 40 Pokos off of the 10,000 Poko goal. Which means that 40 Pokos need to be acquired from enemies. Which is... Oh, hello, you're back. Which is a bit iffy, to be honest. Because normally caves aren't timed. But this one is, in a way. And so getting enemies... Like, from getting treasure from enemies is really sketchy. Alright, so how are we doing this? I'll throw a Pikmin on there. Actually, no. Olimar will get up there. Oh, we can't. Here. No, Olimar will get there. And then... Okay. He'll get up there. And then... I'll throw a Pikmin over there. That's not how you're supposed to do it, but it works. And then I'll throw a Pikmin up there. No, that doesn't work. Throw a Pikmin back there. There you go, Louis. Alright, so now Olimar can get up here. And then I can throw a Pikmin back up. Get up here. It's working like a really awkward ladder, but it is indeed working. And then throw a Pikmin here. Neat. Get on to the highest platform. And let's see that. This is the one. This is the counterweight. Okay, so Olimar is up. He's officially up. Now, that means I need to throw... What do you say? Throw 20 Pikmin? That looks like a 20 Pikmin treasure. 20 Pikmin up onto this block. This puzzle's a lot easier than I thought it would be. But 20 Pikmin up there. And then a bunch more onto this block to counterweight them and raise them up to Olimar's level. Nice. Let's whistle them. Alright, looks like we did it. That was surprisingly easy, and honestly, I probably could have done that with one captain. And I have one Pikmin to spare. Neat, okay, so that's all we need to do. So for the rest of the day, I'll just dismiss most of my Pikmin here, leave them with Louis, and then Olimar can get some sprays, because I need all the sprays I can get. I really do. And I need all of my Pikmin to be flower Pikmin as well. So, let's do that. Get as many bitter sprays as possible. That'll be actually pretty crucial. Here, knock that guy down. There we go. Kill him. Kill him. There, good job. Kill him too. Kill him too. Yeah. Alright. So we got them. And now let's get some sprays. That works, that's fine. You guys can do that. Actually, you know what? I don't need all these Pikmin here. Let's just throw them up, or throw them down there. Because Louis's here, and that's the important thing. And otherwise, I can just throw Pikmin back up there when I need to enter the cave. That sounds like a plan. Alright. And also, then that means... What are you doing? You could just go this way, sir. That means the rest of the day I can dedicate to working up the nerve to to face that cave. So, while I'm doing this, there is something I would like to talk about, and actually, also while I'm doing that, what are you doing? Just go in a straight line. You're weird. That means also, I can talk about one of the weird things that I actually don't like about Pikmin 2, that I just found out, so it's not like I've thought about this my entire childhood. This is new to me, but I found out that the enemies that I talked about talked about earlier in this adventure as appearing in the perplexing pool every day, I was nervous about them. I would check for them. I would say, we need to be careful that there's not a bull bear here. They're not actually here, because how the area works is there is changes over time. I've talked about this. This is a familiar topic. And what that means is that certain enemies only appear on later days. So the enemies that appear here, massage girdle. Huh. Okay. Well, we needed that. So the enemies that appear here, that I was talking about, there's the last above ground treasure. They appear after day 30. Yeah, not 20, not 15, 30, which is dumb, because that means, obviously in the book, it says that you can complete this game pretty easily in 14 days, which I'm not doing because I want to extend this adventure as long as possible. Also, let's just go ahead and grab some yellows. Yeah, let's grab some yellows and give this to the yellows. I want to extend this game as long as possible. But the problem with that is that, I'm trying to extend this game as long as possible, but I'm good at the game, which means that I'm going to be completing it in a short amount of time, which means that I'll never get to see those enemies because they appear so far away. Like, we have 18 days to go before they appear, and that's not cool. I'll never get to see them unless I decide to purposefully stall the game and just start a day and then end the day and then do that 18 times. And that's really dumb. I'll never get to see those enemies. So I guess I'll talk about it now. There will be a point in this adventure where I will be advancing my day count artificially for the purposes of the story and also being able to see those enemies. But not only is there a bull bear that will appear in the perplexing pool, but also, we fought it last episode for the first time, but right where that circle is over there in the clearing, there is a beady long legs that will appear after day 30 in that area, which means that there is an above ground for the first time, actually. Well, no, I guess not the first time, because we saw the burrowing snagret. But there's a substantially sized boss in the above ground area of the perplexing pool. And you can't see it because they don't appear until much, much later. But yeah, there are two bosses. Now, like I said, I'll be showing this off one day. But it really just kind of gimps or hamstrings any potential threat factor this area has. Like, I was expecting, right when I came here with the yellow Pikmin, to have to face a bull bear. Right when I came here. I didn't have yellow Pikmin yet, I just had reds. That's literally all I had. And I was expecting to fight a bull bear. But there's no bull bear, because it's not how things work. It's really kind of sad, but it is what it is. Okay, so with that out of the way, I'm ready to go into... I don't want to say that. I am ready to go into... the cave. I will have to flower my Pikmin first, but that's simple. I have all the sprays I really want. Okay. We're doing it. Like I said, this cave is pretty scary. Now, it's scary for multiple reasons. I've talked about, you know, every cave I've said, oh, this is one of the most dreaded ones in Pikmin 2. And I didn't mean to say that, but honestly, at the time, I dreaded the cave. And caves are kind of scary. You're alone, you don't have an onion, you can't take out more Pikmin. If you lose Pikmin, it's essentially Pikmin with permadeath, to be completely honest. And Pikmin with permadeath is scary. It's really terrifying. But this cave in particular has... an air of menace about it going in, because A, it's in the middle of the water. which is weird for a cave to be. But it also means that you have to take... Let's see, how close am I to another spray? You know what? I'm gonna do it. It's so close. It means that I have to take, I have to take all blues in there. So if there are any other hazards, any other elemental hazards, I have to find a way to circumvent them. And I know for a fact that there are other elemental hazards in that cave, but I'm taking all blues. So there's a security where you, that I would have that is gone. The security of saying, oh, well, I'm immune to all elements as they're presented. That's gone. Because I'm not anymore. Also, why am I doing that? There are going to be some spare Pikmin. Okay, did you guys take those back? Yes, you did. And that's 5? I believe that's 5. So I'll go grab them, and then Louie can enter the cave with all of my Pikmin. Oh, boy. This is going to be rough. Especially since we're timed in that cave. Is this 4? This is 4. It's not enough. Oh, no, it is. Okay. Alright, Louie. Hit it. There's some Pikmin dancing there. They're excited, but I don't understand why. This is the Submerged Castle. Interesting. Deeper sections of this hole seem to be submerged in liquid. Sadly, I am a delicate piece of machinery that is sensitive to water. You two must go alone. Why do you look at me with such scornful expressions? I am an expensive machine! Fine, I'll go. But this wantonly reckless treatment of company property will be reported. Imagine, oh man, the threat level of him not being with us, that'd be even worse. No! Okay, well, Olimar's gonna have to go too, I guess. that would have been bad. Actually, no, there's a strategy that I want to do. This is a little bit weird, but there is a new mechanic in this area, oopsie, that warrants me going in with 85. Yeah, that sounds right. That sounds okay. So I'm going in with 85, which is new and interesting, but it's something that I will have to do because there are more than, as you can see when I selected the cave there, there are more elements in there than just water. There's fire, there's poison, I believe there's everything in there. Now, there's a new mechanic as well that will be introduced that warrants me taking fewer than 100 Pikmin in. So that's another reason. Well, I mean, I guess you guys wouldn't know, and anyone playing for their first time would not understand that, and they wouldn't do that, but I am. I just didn't think it would be introduced here. Alright, the Submerged Castle. Fire, water, electricity, and poison. We're going in with 85 Pikmin, 4 sprays to our name, and a lot of fear. Let's go. The Submerged Castle. Now, this cave is not one that I want to dally in. I do need to get every single enemy, but only up to 60 Pokos, I believe. All right, let's do this. But this cave has a timer on it. You can't see it. You never know it's there. But there is a 5-minute timer that carries onward through every single sub-level. Now, this is bad because after that 5 minutes ends, something happens. Let me just put it this way. You don't want to find out what happens. All right. So I'm going to get as behind this guy as possible. And throw my Pikmin! Kill him quickly! Fiery Bull Blacks! Kill him before he can kill my Pikmin! Yes! That's one of the first times I ever remember in my life being able to kill a Fiery Bull Blacks without losing a single Pikmin without using a spray. Alright, take all of these back. There are 2 treasures that this Bull Blacks was guarding, one inside it, one behind it. Okay. And just the threat, like, this cave is scary if... Really? If only for the, Oh, really? That's dumb. This cave is scary if only for the reason of the music. This music is absolutely terrifying, Bugbait. Okay. Leave. Get the Pikmin! Okay. This cave is scary, if only for a reason of... No! The music. It's absolutely horrifying. There are moans in the background. It's very slow, and there's no real tempo to it. Which is one thing that people were talking about in the comments. They said one of the music... No, one of the reasons why Pikmin music is so good is because it doesn't really have a tempo. And it makes it so it feels like it's real life. Like, there isn't tempo to life. Life doesn't follow a real rhythm, right? And neither should this game. Okay, take that out. Once again, I need to rush. Kill him. Whistle them back. And carry this back. Come on. Go. Oh, there's another treasure. Oh, hello. I almost missed it. Grab this. Is that it? Okay, I think that's it. Now, once again... Oh, and also, notice that. In the very first sub-level of the entire cave, they're giving me the option to leave. The first sub-level, and they're like, you know what? If you don't want to get into this, you can leave. And we don't blame you. In fact, you should. And that's just scary. It's scary as all get out. Okay, into the cave we go. Once again, I'm timed on these. I have to hurry. Going in. Okay. I don't know how many enemy treasures or enemy Pokos we've gotten, but we still need to get some. And then, I'm guessing by sub-level 3, we will run out on the timer. Maybe this one, I'm not sure. I probably have spent a minute 30 doing things. Ugh. I'm terrified, guys. Alright. Kill him. Come on, kill him. You're not gonna throw things at the gate, will you? Hopefully not. That would be dumb. Oh, hey! There it is! That's our mechanic. That's why I took less than 100 Pikmin in. Come on, throw it. Okay. Blow up the mother. Will it blow up the mother? Yeah, it will. Well, that's neat. Thanks. These are a new kind of Pikmin. Yes, they are. However many episodes into the series, this is a confused Bulborb that has fallen in with the Pikmin. They appear to coexist peacefully. Strange. This Bulborb has a leaf sprouting from its spine, much like the leaf on a Pikmin's head. This is a Bulbman. And these guys are special. Do you remember how... Really? I don't want that. I don't want your garbage. You guys remember how enemies, like normal enemies, aren't weak to elements? Well, that's gonna be bad. They aren't weak to elements? Well, neither are the Bulbmen. They are immune to everything, which is why I took, because you can't have more than 100 Pikmin on the field, that's why I took 85, because we get Bulbmen. Now, these guys don't have an onion, and they aren't stored into the ship. We lose them as soon as we leave the cave. But they're a way to artificially bolster our numbers while having an immunity to different elemental hazards. Now, they aren't every Pikmin combined. You can't just say that. Oh, boy. You can't just say that, because that would be discounting purple Pikmin, and they're not purple Pikmin. Oh, boy. I remember that area over there. All right, I need to rush. I think I might run out of the 5 minutes here. Run. Okay. Nice. Kill him. Oi! Nice. Kill him. I don't have much time left. I don't have the time left. I'm pretty sure I will run out in this sub-level. Come on, Louis, sleep! Thank you. You can see that I'm getting really flustered because I know what's coming. And as it's at this point that I need to split up my squad. Come on, kill him! Okay, good. Okay. Throw them there. That should be 10. Good. Oh, snap, I need to bring these enemies back. I need to bring the enemies back. Go, go. Okay. I need to split up the squad for multiple reasons. One of which is to get as much as I want done. But the other reason is because there is an enemy here that will target a specific squad member. I thought it was there. Good thing is that I'm safe here. I am safe here. Get in here! I'm definitely gonna run out of the 5 minutes here. Come on, come on, come on. All right. You carry this as fast as possible. And, oh, I was scared. I was so scared there. I know I'm gonna run out of time on this sub-level. I just need to get as many things in as possible. Okay, chocolate cushion. I fell down there. Real quick, Olimar. Actually, no. Throw that on there. Good. Okay, I have one Bulbman left. Okay. Where is it? When is it gonna happen? It's gonna happen this sub-level, for sure. But when? Ed, can I check how many Pokos I have? Can I do that? Okay, I'm getting there. I need you guys to fall down pretty quick. Come on. I can't get up to them. They're going to be attracted by the treasure. Oh boy, I'm so scared, guys. It looks like I won't be able to get them, actually. But I think I should be fine regardless. Go, go, go. Let's whistle them. Is that getting places? I think it is. Alright, let's carry the Careening Dirigi Bug back. And overall, I think I might have forestalled death here. I might have been able to forestall death and stall it off until the next floor. Just take this down. Take this down pretty quick. These ridges are a little bit hard to circumvent. Dismiss all the Pikmin here. Alright. I think we did it. I think we're good. You know, Future Pal, if you can, I'm not sure if I have this capability on my editing software. Could you put a 5 minute timer maybe? Or would that be might be a bit too weird, because then you guys get to know exactly where when it's gonna happen. But I don't know, maybe that adds to the suspense. You use your judgment on that, Future Pal. Alright. We're going in the next floor. Wasn't able to get those Dweevils. Hopefully that won't necessarily matter. I think I only need like 60 Pokos, 50, 40, something like that, in order to complete the debt. Mistake. That was kind of lame. Especially after he's like, "You are of a strong personality. I need you to save my people." And then the guy he talks. No, okay. It focuses the active captain! Okay. It focuses the active captain, which is a way I can... No!